Good morning. Presenting in English is not my everyday job, so apologize for that. I'm working at the Netherlands Institute for Sound and Vision on behalf of the Dutch Digital Heritage Network. And I will explain today what it is all about. And I will start my presentation with a short introduction on the National Strategy for Digital Heritage. How did we start it 7 years ago, and what are underlying principles? After this, I will zoom in on some of the major networking aspects, working with a manifesto, cooperation with software vendors, and building a network of support. Our work is based on a long-term vision on implementing linked data principles at the level of heritage organizations, and I will give some highlights of it. And I will end my presentation with some major lessons learned. The Dutch heritage sector consists of a variety of more than 1,500 organizations and historical societies. At first glance, it seems that we face more differences than similarities. But we felt a strong need in aligning the digital activities of all those heritage organizations. A crucial part of this challenge is to improve the capabilities of institutions to share their information in the network and to integrate digital heritage information from various sources to build services for their audiences. Since 2015, the implementation of the strategy has been entrusted to the Digital Heritage Network. And this network of heritage institutions has accepted the challenge of further developing the strategy, together with parties of all sizes from the heritage sector. It all started with the initiative of 5 national heritage hubs. And you see them on the screen: the Royal Library of the Netherlands, the National Archives, the Institute of Sound and Vision, the Cultural Heritage Agency, and the Humanities Cluster of the Royal Netherlands Academy of Arts and Sciences. As national hubs, they act as role models by making their collections accessible and visible according to the shared principles. This means actively contributing to the network of terms and the dataset registry, making their own data available as linked data, and ensuring sustainable storage. These hubs also use their organizational capacity, facilities, knowledge, and budget for the heritage sector as a whole. And last but not least, the ongoing support of the Ministry of Culture is one of the keys to success. Yeah. Last year, we published the second version of the National Strategy. And you can find this on our website. This can be seen as an evidence of the longer-term goals we pursue with the network. We share common principles. The aim of the strategy is to make it easier for people to find their way through our digital heritage collections. And that is why we focus on users. Connecting heritage information from archives, libraries, museums, and the smaller local historical societies is central to this. And we see linked data as a key. So we worked the past 6 years according 3 layers: digital heritage sustainable, usable, and visible. The publication of a position paper about the design principles for the discovery infrastructure in 2015 was a huge milestone. At that time, some of our colleagues told us that we were aiming for the moon. Linked data was quite uncommon. Luckily, we persisted in applying the design principles, such as referring to data instead of copying, standardization of data instead of software, and building service portals as dynamic views based on a common interconnected data layer. A cross-domain reference architecture is essential in the Dutch approach implementing linked data. And luckily, we found the Ministry of Culture on our side. They adopted the Digital Heritage reference infrastructure and are working on it together with information architects of the National Heritage Hubs. The reference architecture describes how linked data and techniques can be used to collaborate across the boundaries of institutions and sectors. And as a heritage institution, you can see what role you can play in the digital heritage network and what is needed for that. The national strategy and the reference architecture form both the guideline and the desired situation for digital heritage. So how we are building the network of people and the network of linked data. At the beginning, we formulated a manifesto. At the beginning, we formulated a manifesto and we asked heritage organizations to endorse it by signing it. And after each endorsement, we donated a cake for the whole organization. And we stopped with it because it was quite a lot of work. The manifesto consists of 5 short statements and ends with the statement that together we are responsible for our memory of the Netherlands. Central to this is the idea that we no longer think and act as separate institutions, but as a network. Together we can take bigger steps. For a long period, the relationship between heritage institutions and IT suppliers can be described as us against them. There was a lot of mistrust back and forth. Then we got the idea to organize so-called fireside meetings at the beach. Low profile, small and informal meetings with the 5 major vendors. During these meetings, we shared our vision on standardization based on the reference architecture, linked data principles, and we discussed the implementation of these principles in their software. In the end, vendors embraced our vision, not all in the same way, and there was still enough to choose from. And not only heritage institutions endorsed the manifesto, also, the main software vendors in the Dutch heritage sector were enthusiastic about signing it. And this was an important step in what became a close cooperation with them. And this cooperation resulted in a networking event earlier this year, where the IT suppliers presented new versions of their software compatible with the national strategy. This was a big win, because in this way we reach almost 80% of all the heritage organizations. And the big challenge now is the implementation. How do you know whether you can share and connect information with others from your collection management system in a simple and standardized manner? By using a simple checklist, you learn more about the possibilities of the software you use. Connecting and sharing heritage data works easiest with software that supports all functionalities. And with these criteria, we can test the compatibility of software based on the principles formulated in the reference architecture. A frequently asked question is, where do I have to start? We all know the diversity and complexity of the digital heritage landscape we work in. It can be overwhelming to find your way, and you quickly get lost in technical questions, standards, and a variety of software solutions. Our answer was creating a network of digital heritage coaches. In every region of the Netherlands, you can find a coach who can help you. And every 6 weeks, we organize a meeting with the group of digital heritage coaches. They share expertise, experiences, and best practices. And we provide them with tools, such as an information planner, a practical how-to guide to write an information plan in 5 steps, an online timetable, digital heritage, and a toolbox with all kinds of digital heritage tools. Altogether, this can be seen as a network of support. So, what is our current work? We develop key components in a shared discovery infrastructure of linked heritage data. Our focus is more and more on implementation and use of tools and shared services. All activities are still based on the principles formulated in the position paper about the discovery architecture. And we also delivered services such as the dataset registry, PIT implementations, and standardized vocabularies. A search engine has been developed. We call it the network of terms. Based on a keyword such as Rembrandt, the network of terms search directly in various terminology sources for matching terms and returns the corresponding identifiers. As I earlier mentioned, the major vendors implemented this functionality of the network of terms in their software. The network of terms is managed by the Cultural Heritage Agency on behalf of the network. And the purpose of the dataset registry is to gain insight into heritage datasets. If you want to become visible in the network, your institute is asked to describe these datasets and to publish them online in the dataset registry. And again, the major vendors implemented a direct and automated link to the dataset registry in their software. And the dataset registry is managed by the National Archives on behalf of the network. We publish all the results in the form of requirements and specifications, and you can find them on our GitHub. These documents describe how IT suppliers can help the Dutch cultural heritage institutions to become more compliant with the principles for cooperation in the network. We ask IT suppliers of data management and publication software to implement the guidelines in their products. And this will help the Dutch heritage institutions in making their information accessible to machines and humans on the web. The use of these shared services is, of course, not visible for end users. To give you an example, Van Gogh Worldwide offers extensive information about more than 1,000 paintings, prints, and drawings in Dutch heritage institutions. And recently, this also includes works from collections abroad. All data is published directly from the participating organizations themselves as linked data and linked to each other via the Van Gogh Worldwide infrastructure. This makes this platform an example for linking information according to the national strategy principles. And for us, it's a wonderful showcase. We stimulate heritage institutions to take steps to publish their collection information as linked data, especially in schema.org, to increase the visibility in Google and other major search engines. To lower the barriers for contributing data to Europeana, we designed a basic pipeline, the LOT aggregator, that harvests the published linked data and converts the schema.org information to the Europeana data model, ADM, to make the ingest in the Europeana harvesting platform possible. The LOT aggregator was a result of international cooperation within the Common Culture Project. And we are implementing the pipeline as one of the preferred ways to deliver content to Europeana. So what are some lessons learned so far, to conclude? Innovations in the field of digitization are moving quite fast, and it's a challenge to make the right choices. It's a challenge to make the right choices based on sustainability and on wise decisions. We experience a difference in pace between larger and smaller institutions, and we have to deal with differences in budget, in expertise, and in the size of staff, for example. And this is one of the reasons why we think that moving in the right direction is more important than doing everything right. And the differences are an important driver for cooperation in the Digital Heritage Network. We are not a formal organization, and we don't want to become a formal organization. In the network, we identify gaps, stimulate the development of network-wide solutions, and support implementations based on a coherent vision of sustainability, usability, and visibility of digital heritage in the broadest sense of the word. After all, the national strategy is not only a strategy for digitization, but above all, a strategy for further cooperation. Thank you.